32% of UK mosques experience attacks in the past 3 years, new report finds. A recent report by Muslim Census and Engagement and Development, or MEND for short, surveyed 113 out of the 1,800 mosques and Islamic institutions in the United Kingdom. The report revealed that out of those surveyed, roughly 42% had experienced a religiously motivated attack within the past 3 years, including 4 arson attacks. At least 15% of these institutions noticed a rise in the attacks during the height of the pandemic. The episodes were usually accompanied by vandalism, burglary, and at times physical assault of staff. 9% of those surveyed said that they were targeted as frequently as every 3 months. Data from the UK Home Office revealed that between March of 2020 and March of 2021, 45% of religious hate crime offenses were against Muslims. Mosque officials and attendees said that repeated vandalism and social media threats had taken a toll on their well-being, and the attacks and harassment had a negative effect on their wider community. So this was really interesting to me, this new data. Now, just so you guys know, this comes from two organizations. They are called Muslim Census and Muslim Engagement and Development. And they're the ones who conducted this study. So this isn't peer reviewed or anything. But this was very valuable information. I was shocked to learn that between 2020 and 2021, almost half of religious hate crimes in the UK were against Muslims. They were the largest community like to be targeted. Actually, I might need to check that.
Yeah, I thought Jewish people were the most targeted. No, I was wrong.
I have to check in terms of like which group actually was the highest percentage. I don't remember that off the top of my
maybe
head.
That's but in,
still,
maybe,
nearly half.
Maybe in Europe, the highest is Jewish, but in UK, the highest is...
Yeah, between 1 year. Yeah. So what do you think of these statistics? I was actually really surprised about the reported frequency.
Like how frequently is it? Like I'm seeing a 42% rise, but...
So out of the mosques that were surveyed, almost half, like 42%, had experienced some sort of attack within the past 3 years. Hmm. And then 9% said that they have episodes of harassment or violence or...
And what are we defining as an attack?
There were a couple of different examples. So... Actually, that's a really good point, because when I read the report today, and they reference people coming in and stealing items out of people's belongings, stealing people's wallets, stealing donations,
no!
stealing cell phones.
No, that's not... Okay.
They talk about that within the same sentence as attack, but then they also talk about burglary separately. So I'm like, okay, just because you're burgled, I don't know.
Okay. This study needs to be analyzed, okay? Because if they're considering robbery, okay, as an attack, then this study might be very misleading because let me tell you, shoes being lost or people stealing your stuff in a mosque is a time-old tradition, okay, that has nothing to do with anti-Islam attacks or anti-Muslim
time-old
hatred, okay?
Tradition.
Yeah, this is like as old as Islam itself, okay? The first mosque when Muhammad the first was mosque was Muhammad's house, okay? And I could tell you that probably someone stole Muhammad's shoes on the very first day that somebody, this is like part of Islamic tradition, okay? People steal your stuff in a mosque, okay? So if they're adding that to attack on mosques, then this is going to be very misleading. Like people are like, oh my God, the attacks on Muslims is 42% of UK mosques. This is Muslim, if this is an attack, this is Muslim on Muslim violence, okay? If shoe stealing is considered an anti-mosque attack, then this is Muslim on Muslim, okay? Can somebody look at the study, what they consider? Good thing I asked what they consider an attack, because I will, this study would be very misleading if they consider theft. Theft as like
Imran is saying, yes, can confirm, Mal.
Yes. I
Okay, so here are some other key findings from the report. Almost half of mosques or Islamic institutions we surveyed experienced religiously motivated attacks in the past 3 years. So that's what I just said. The most common form of attack experienced by mosques is vandalism followed by theft. So the number two type of attack is a threat.
Okay, this is going to be so misleading. People are going to look at this report. Theft, they're counting theft. So theft is just people showing up at mosque and stealing your shoes, and you're like, I don't know, you're like, you're putting your cell phone somewhere and somebody takes it. And people are going to think like, oh my God, 42%. Guys, this is like, this has nothing to do with attacks on mosques. This is part of going to mosque. This is why you don't wear your best shoes to the mosque. This is why you usually just wear... No, yeah, this is why you wear slippers to your mosque. This is why you wear slippers. You go to the mosque with slippers. Okay? Like, what? Okay, like, people are going to take these numbers and going to run and be like, oh, look at all these anti-Muslim hate, 42% attacks on that mosque. They're considering theft as attack. Like, they're making it seem like, oh, in UK, people, they're going and stealing your shoes because they're anti-Muslim. Not knowing that this is just part of going to, like, this is just a normal experience of going to the mosque. Are they stealing your shoe because, like, we hate Islam. Like, let's show these Muslims that, like, do you think, like, Christians and atheists are going to mosque and just stealing Muslim shoes? Do they think this is what's happening? We got your shoes, Muslims. Like, you're trying to invade this country? No, like, I know they're citizens there. I'm being a bigot here, okay? Like,
you're personifying, you. Yeah.
Yeah, you come to our country, we'll take your shoes.
You took our culture, we take your shoes. I like your idea of how this went down better. the rest of the study gets into things like how often the communities that they surveyed reported these incidents to police, about their confidence level in the police, do they think that the police will work with them, and then also about how the UK government has this payment scheme to help religious institutions basically afford security and prevent some forms of harassment, vandalism, or hate crime. Well, and it's like how the government has made it too difficult for Islamic institutions or the ones that they surveyed to meet the barrier of getting into this program.
Install cameras.
No, it's to help you pay for them expense. Okay, yeah.
Can I get some government money? They steal my shoes, like, as well. Okay. what is
okay?
This,
like, this is about a lot more than just stealing stuff. Why is though, because there was like a mom that was stabbed.
If there's an Apple store next to the mosque, okay, and somebody comes and steals like phones from the store, does the government come and pay for the Apple store security?
Do they come
and steal? Okay, I don't understand. Just police. Okay. By the way, what percentage of this 42% you said it was like theft?
So the first most out of what they considered thefts, the number one form of theft was vandalism. The second was theft.
Okay.
And they don't actually tell you what that number is. They don't give definitions to what they are considering these criteria.
But I'm not saying there's no attacks on UK mosques. I'm sure like there is, and it's horrible. Okay?
No, I mean, we can find this data in other places, you know. We don't have to rely on these
people. Yeah, and I'm not saying this data is bullcrap, okay? I'm just saying, like, I'm just being skeptical, okay? I don't want to dismiss vandalism or
Darko saying it feels like this study is religiously motivated. I mean, it is literally produced by to Islamic organizations.
Oh my God. Okay, never mind. My skepticism has escalated to new levels now. Okay, so
yeah. Like,
look, government, we have more attacks. Yeah, you need an independent. Again, I'm not saying that these attacks are not large, and I just don't. Is this one of those studies that starts with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim?
No.
Okay, good.
That would be outrageous. No, I mean, just because like a nonprofit institution like produced their own report doesn't make it totally worthless. Like ex-Muslims in North America put out like an amazing apostate report that's basically the first report on ex-Muslims.
Yeah, but just skeptical. So
these things are still valuable.
Yeah, I'm just saying we need to be skeptical. I'm not saying I'm not saying throw it away. I'm just saying like, that's all. I'm just going.
Yeah.
Okay. we're not. Are we being selective with our skepticism? Because I don't think we are. I think like we are careful when things are in our favor. Also, to be like, how the other side might say this. You know, like I think we do a good job here. Yeah. All right. and we have the live chat to remind us if we're not being. Read what Doorknob Head said.
Doorknob Head is saying, okay, follow the money. Who wrote the report and who paid for the study? Good question. They don't talk about their source of funding. I mean, but presumably whoever supports
the institution. But Susanna is also being very fair here, right? She's like, okay, if we're doing that with Muslim studies, we should be doing that for reports by ex-Muslims of North America as well, because you know those people are on their side. We're so fair here. Like, this is the most fair show ever. Like, isn't it?
This
like,
is what you get at Atheist Republic. This is what you get.
Yeah, exactly. Tell your friends.
Hey, guys. If you're a fan of blasphemy and sexy Cali, you know, like me, then you need to be sure to subscribe to our newsletter, link in the description below. Because if you subscribe, we will send you a free copy of our Blasphemous Art ebook. And let me tell you, it is the tastiest blasphemy that you can find anywhere available today. And we are so generous with our blasphemy that we continue to send you more blasphemy every week. So make sure to subscribe, link in the description below.